Hey y'all, it's Stephen Van Kampen-Lewis on February 19th, but I'm gonna show this video on February 26th. In fact, at this time, if you're watching at 10 a.m. Central Standard Time, I will be moving into my new apartment with the rest of the family. So it's kind of a hectic day, but I still get to put a video out because I filmed it last week. So I'm gonna turn the camera around and I'm gonna show you what's going on inside my grow tent, but I'm gonna show you something even more exciting. I got a Cycnoches jarae, or jarae. It's probably jarae, J-A-R-A-E, from Peru Flora by accident. So if you recall at Redlands, I got a few plants and two of them were Cycnoches. I'll show them both to you actually in the grow tent here, but the Cycnoches peruvianum that I got actually bloomed out as jarae, and jarae is really rare in cultivation. So it's one of those errors from the vendor that actually works out really well in my favor. In fact, Peru Flora is kind of known for that. They have a tendency to send out plants that are called one thing, and then it turns out that they're actually something way cooler and way more rare. So, you know, Peru Flora, I can't buy from them online anymore because they've taken my money and they haven't sent me plants before. And that's a pretty common thing with them, but I will definitely buy from them when I see them at a show. In fact, I'm hoping to see them again maybe at Redland in October of 2022. I plan to fly out and do that show again. But anyway, I'm talking too much. Let's turn the camera around and check out some of these plants, including the ultra rare Cycnoches jarae. All right, so let's open her up. Get it to go this way. And check it out. So these are the plants that I have got in here right now. I'm actually gonna start on the left and work my way back around to the Cycnoches jarae here. These are the two doeanas that I have. In fact, this one is still looking terrible, but it's got a new growth, so hopefully it's putting out new roots. This one is still looking okay. I plan to kick these guys out back outside when the weather gets warm. This is Cattleya varsovixii. This is that Bedford clone, or not clone, excuse me, this is a cross using Bedford, and I'm testing it out in the grow tent to see how well it does. These are Cattleya pumilas, and they're doing pretty nice. They were fresh out of flask from the Plant Propagator, which is a really cool channel that I follow. He had some extras, and so I asked him if he had some to distribute, and it turns out that he did. This is Cattleya hardiana. These are, the media kind of soured on me. All of a sudden, it's in the same cypress mulch that you see the varsovixii here, but so I dumped them over into the sphagnum, and they, not gonna lie, they look pretty rough. But we'll see. You know, they've come a long way, and hopefully I don't lose any more, but I can see at least one or two that look really nice, and then some others that are questionable. We'll see how many I end up getting. This is Bulbophyllum denisii. I'll probably sell that one. It's this bush that just won't grow for me, or excuse me, won't bloom for me anymore. And then some other things. Triumphans here, Paraphalaenopsis labucansis, which is doing pretty cool, doing really well under these lights. In fact, as usual, I need to tell you that I got my light from Carnivoro, who's a Drew Martinez is the owner, and he's a friend of mine. He lives just down the road from me. Actually, he works just for that down the road from me. And he makes his own lights. He is an optics guy by training, worked for Google and some other really cool high-tech companies, and then started his own carnivorous plant operation. In fact, that's where I got this Nepenthes vogelii from. Let's see if I can get this. Absolutely beautiful pictures. Great companion plants for indoors. But the Cycnoches, actually, here's the Heron Husseinum that I got from Redlands. It rotted right away. within like a couple of weeks of me getting it, but I've still got this bulb and I moved it into the grow tent to increase the humidity and so it gets access to warmer temperatures, and I'm hoping that it'll wake up. This is a Catasetum peruvianum that I got from Paula Marsh over there at Hillbilly Orchids. This is a division that I got. Again, this has had kind of a colder or cooler winter. Now I'm moving into the grow tent. It's starting to shrivel a bit, so I want it to grow in the grow tent, and hopefully the warmth and the added humidity that comes with this tent will trigger it to wake up. I think it will. And then, of course, the Cycnoches jarae. And let's see if I can zoom in on this flower here. So I am focusing on these lower plants, which are a little easier to film. But you can see, actually, this is, it's a really long chain. This is a first bloom plant. And you can see how long this chain of flowers is. Really cool. Now, as you can see, this is not a showy flower by any means. This is sort of what you call a collector's plant, where only, you know, a handful of folks are super excited about this like I am. Most of the folks growing cattleyas or really showy orchids, you know, maybe going to pick up their plants at their local nurseries or even Lowe's or their local grocery stores, probably not going to be super excited by this, but boy, am I excited by this. This is really cool. Such a bizarre thing. The few photos that I've seen online don't really have this many spots typically, but this lip is really diagnostic of this species. It's very unusual for the Cycnoches. It's like this weird tube that kind of flips around. You know, a lot of the Cycnoches have these lips that are sort of star-shaped, almost looks like a star itself. This clearly does not have that. This is a very different creature all on its own. And it's still an import, so I still have a long way to go before I can say that it's adapted to our climate. In fact, after this video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to collect the pollen from these flowers, probably from every flower, throw them in the fridge, and then cut off the spike. And then if you recall from my video with Fred Clark, where we talked about importing orchids, he said that if you get an orchid out of season, or an import, a Cycnoches or a Catasetum from the fall or winter, like I did, I got this in October, you know, let it do its thing, and then early in February, slam it with cold temperatures. And that should force dormancy and get it to go to sleep and then wake it back up maybe in March or April. So that's what I'm going to do with this one. I'm going to cut this off. I'm going to put it in my windowsill, which gets down to about 50 degrees at night, and that should trigger dormancy. I've got another import that I got this summer that I have treated the same. That's Cycnoches egertonianum. But of course, I'm going to make sure that this media is dry. So you can see that this media here is still wet. So what I'm going to do, I haven't watered this in 3 or 4 weeks maybe, but I'm going to make sure that this is dry, and then I'm going to give it that cold, those cold nights in the windowsill, and that should trigger dormancy, and then hopefully it'll wake up in a month or two when I put it back into warmer growing conditions. What a weird little thing, huh? Very unexpected. Very cool. Very glad to have it. And I will see you next weekend. Bye.